joy, right, joy. Have a holly jolly Christmas.
My name is Ed Howie, and this is Howie Grow A Brand. If you like what you learned from this video, help us promote this channel by clicking the like button below and subscribing to our channel, Howie Grow A Brand. Ready to go? Let's get into today's chat. Who's got the joy? We got the joy. Do you have the joy? Because we got the joy. And is there joy in your brand? Well, let me tell you, if there is, you need to celebrate it. If there isn't, you better not celebrate it, because you'll be celebrating a lie. You know, that's what we're talking about today. We're talking about holiday marketing, and I will not be wearing these bad boys. I don't know. Do you hear like sleigh bells? Sleigh bells? Rudolph? Oh my gosh, Rudolph. I mean, seriously, is that not one of the best shows ever? All right, so we're talking about holiday marketing. Happy holidays to you. Merry Christmas to you. You know, it is the most wonderful time of the year for many people, and it's not always the most wonderful time for everyone. And the reality is, throughout the year, your customers, your brand community, celebrates multiple holidays. And so how do you know how to navigate it? So let's talk about holiday marketing and how you handle marketing holidays. Well, I will tell you that it is something that I struggle with in our advice and counsel to brands, because I believe everything we do has to be authentic. When it comes to holiday marketing, I would encourage you to be very deliberate and not just let your social media intern look at the calendar and determine, we're gonna have to have a post for all these holidays, all right? Because the worst marketing you can offer is marketing that is not true. I will tell you, I'm a Christian. We say Merry Christmas, all right? We encourage brands who want to say Merry Christmas to say Merry Christmas. But we do recognize Hanukkah as well, okay? And so the deal is that it just has to be authentic to what the personality of your brand is. And that's where we come to joy. Joy in marketing, joy in the holidays. You know, I don't know about you, but the last 2 years have been really a challenge to the joy factor, because there's been so much fear and so much anxiety and so much isolation. So, have a little joy. I'm going to share with you two or three of some of my most favorite holiday commercials this season. Here's the first one.
Once upon a time, there was a reindeer named Tiptoe, and everyone just knew Tiptoe could fly.
Shouldn't you be getting ready for your flying test?
It's nearly Christmas!
Me? Fly? Maybe next year.
Everyone, that is, except Tiptoe.
She's just scared.
But flying is awesome. I flew once in an airplane.
Wait, that's it.
They gave us snacks and earphones. I watched like 10 movies. No.
So Tiptoe's friends visited the North Pole's greatest makers, who came up with their greatest invention yet.
Ta-da!
Wow. What is it exactly?
It's a barometrically elevating levitation instigation engine with vehicular enhancement.
It's a flying machine!
It works! Tell Santa I'll do the test!
Mm-hmm. Huh? Oh,
oh, oh,
whoa!
Oh, no!
It's a barometrically elevating levitation instigation engine with vehicular enhancement.
I just have to believe.
From that day on, Tiptoe was never scared to fly again, because she realized the courage she needed was in herself all along. So, you ready to fly to Grandma's?
Okay.
All right, so here's another one of like my all-time favorite holiday commercials.
Thank you.
Salut, papa.
Joyeux Noël.
Take a look at this one.
Christmas is a time for closeness, and closeness is what Norelco razors are all about. The shiny new silver rotary razors in cord and rechargeable models with 36 blades, 9 closeness settings, and no gotchas. And the Ladybugs, the ladies' razors that really work. And the Ladybug Salon, a ladybug razor plus 11 grooming attachments. Norelco, even our name says Merry Christmas.
Don't these bring joy? I mean, these like are authentic celebrations of the holiday and what the holidays mean, and kind of like how like the brand at least fits within the storyline. Now, let me tell you about a commercial. Let me show you a commercial that stopped me in my tracks. It came on a little too early, frankly. It came on early November. But look at this most incredible storytelling about joy and Christmas.
People say that we don't know.
Santa looks good.
I got it. Don't worry.
Okay. Okay. All right. Everybody, stand up straight.
That's you. Okay. There you are. Okay. Now let me flip it.
Okay. Now, seriously. And I'm not trying to bash Walmart because there are a lot of things they do well. But when was the last time you walked into Walmart and experienced joy? I mean, think about it, truly. When is the last time you walked into a Walmart and experienced joy? Now, let me tell you about my last two experiences that I had in Walmart as a result to going to Walmart because I saw this ad and they came back into my consideration, because so many times I've gone into Walmart and really it just took forever to get out of there, frankly. You know what I mean? So two times in the last 2 weeks, I need to go to Walmart. And I really went back to Walmart and they were in my consideration set because I saw that joyous commercial. Okay, so first thing, I had to go to get a glass shield for this iPhone 11. Because you know what? AT&T doesn't care about the 11 now. They're all about converting you to the 13 and getting more money. And Apple Store doesn't have anything for the 11 either. And this 11 Pro Max. And anyway, I had this cracked glass shield on my iPhone. Frustrating. Couldn't find it. I thought, oh, I wonder if Walmart has it. Guess what? Walmart had it. Amazing. So I actually went on the app and it told me exactly F7, which aisle to go to find it. And I knew that it was in the store because they told me that. I got there. I found it. I had to wait 5 minutes for someone to unlock the cabinet so that I could get it, because I guess they thought I was going to steal it. So they did let me take it out to the front cash register, which was my biggest mistake. Because you know what? Walmart has, let's be liberal, 24 cash registers. Actually, more like 35, 36. But let's just say 24 cash registers. And then they have 8 self-checkout stands. Guess what? Not a single cash register opened at 5:30 on a Saturday during the holiday season. Everything was being funneled to self-checkout. Guess what? There were 30 people in self-checkout. For me to buy that one little glass thing, it took me more time than it took me to drive to the Walmart, find aisle F7, and get back home. That ain't joy, baby. So I said, anomaly, short staffing. We all understand. Hey, we run businesses. We know it's tough times. So 3 days later, I'm on a business trip. My Fitbit watch cracks. And you know what? If I'm walking and if I'm burning calories, I want credit. So I look up, hey, maybe Walmart has the band for the Fitbit. Because you know what? They have everything. Guess what? They had it. It was aisle F11. It was 9 o'clock on a Tuesday night. And guess what? Same thing happened. Pulled into the Walmart. I was on a business trip. Found it. It was not far from the hotel. Go to the Walmart. Go directly to the aisle. Get there. It's locked up. I get it. I understand. Shrink control. Get it. Go. Not a single human-operated cash register open at all. That ain't joy. So Walmart, I love the way your commercial makes me feel. I do not love the way your operation makes me feel. So here's the deal. If your operation doesn't reflect joy, you better not be celebrating the joy of your brand in your commercials, no matter how cinematic they are. Get it? So let's talk about joy that resonates. How can you not think joy when you think of Oreos? That was a little Oprah-like. Oreos! Oreos for you! Oreos for you! Well, look at these Oreos that are available only this holiday season from our friends at the Oreo Company. I mean, talk about on-brand joy. Unless there is an allergy to something in Oreos, they create joy. And look, there's now holiday collection Oreos. I haven't had an Oreo in months. I want one of these. Joy Oreo Authentic. Joy Walmart Aspirational. You know, whether it's holiday marketing or everyday marketing, if your message does not ring true with the experience your customer receives from your brand, you better figure out another message, because not telling the truth in marketing is exactly how you kill a brand. And we're here to grow a brand. And we're here to be joyous. So Merry Christmas. Happy Kwanzaa. Joy to all. I hope this helps and inspires your day. If any of this works on your business this week, I'd love to hear about it in the comments, or please message me directly. Can't wait to see what we chat about on the next episode. We'll see you soon.